Yo. What's up, everybody? How's it going? Yeah, what Wolf, what up, man? How you doing? My man Josh, what's up, brother? Good to see ya. Nick Porter, what up, brother? What's up, man? How's everybody doing today? You just graduated college. Congratulations. And get a job. Go make some money, dude. Go make some money. Good, man. How's everybody doing tonight? How's everybody doing? Dude, I appreciate the hearts. Appreciate the hearts. Appreciate that. What time do I wake up at, like, 6:30-ish. 6:30. Getting up, doing things. The shirt is a, it's a Ted Baker. What up? Sergio here from Los Angeles, California. How's the weather over in sunny Miami? Dude, it's all right. It's kind of chilly. Thank you. Guys, if you don't know who I am, my name's Steve Spray. Work with the godfather of sales, Grant Cardone. So you guys are always asking a bunch of questions. I get a bunch of messages all the time on Facebook. You guys who follow me on Instagram, at Steve Spray, you guys are freaking always banging up my Instagram on questions, so I figured I'd get on and handle and answer them. So what kind of questions do you guys have right now? Let me fix the lighting. Let me fix the lighting for you. There we go. Might be better. Oh yeah, much better. Much better. Alright guys. Yeah. Great job with Dave the other night. Thank you. You guys like that? You like when we get on there and we do, the role plays, getting your pitch right, working out the pitch. Man, everybody asks about the pitch, so we always want to help out, you know, with that for sure. How do I deal with haters? Dude, I don't know, man. I just don't really think about them anymore, you know? I almost, like, welcome them because it's, like, sometimes it just gets so boring without them, you know? If you don't have haters, then you should be worried. You should be figuring it out, dude, because there's always going to be somebody banging on you like, oh, dude, those guys down there at Dan Komen's, man, they do this, they do that, blah, 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 blah. Dude, it's because they don't do shit, right? Dude, that's anybody who's been hating, man. It's a validation. It's a validation that you're doing something right because, you know, when you build up success like that, there's going to be some haters. Guys, I appreciate you giving me hearts. If you don't know who I am, my name's Steve Spray. I work with the Godfather Sales, Grant Cardone. I wanted to get on and answer some questions that you guys have. Morning routine. Dude, I wake up every single morning and do the exact same thing. So I wake up every morning and I go on my Cardone University. You guys probably see me blast out on Twitter the courses that I actually study every morning. So if you guys ever want to know what I'm studying, and you're following me on Twitter, you can just see me. I blast it every single morning. You'll see the courses that I train on every day. So I do my training, I skill up, get my game on, my head right, and then I go to the gym. So I go to the gym downstairs, work out, you know. I've been lifting a little bit lately, trying to get all, you know, pumped back up again, you know what I'm saying? But, I typically I'll run. I just got, you know, bored with that, so now I'm back to lifting a little bit. I won't do that too long. I'll go back to running. And then what I do is I come up, I make breakfast, you know, because you got to eat every morning. And then I cruise to work. When I'm cruising to work, I'm not wasting time. I'm actually listening to things. Or I'm making phone calls. So I'll call clients in the morning. Like when I'm in the car, I'm like, dude, I'm calling clients. Who can I call right now just to say, hey, what's up, man? How you doing? How you doing today? Yeah, Brett Coffee says, I love the new cold calling module in Cardone University. Dude, the reason why you love it is because it's freaking sick. I had a guy text me today. Just hooked him up on the program. His company got hooked up. He's already texted me on two different occasions. He said, dude, blasted out three deals today from that program. Freaking sick. And that's it, man, because the guy's too busy. He's closing deals. So, I don't know, man. It's a great deal. And I've been telling people about it for, you know, I've been on the program. You know, I've been training with Grant's material for 5 years. You know, different books, audios, things like that. Now, dude, I never did the CrossFit thing. I never did CrossFit. That was Dave and Jordan. But I did used to work out. If you guys follow the Bar Stars and Miami Beach, South Beach. You find the Bar Stars. You can find their videos on YouTube. They got some good shit. I used to work out with them when I lived on South Beach. That was cool. I really miss that. But now I live on the other side, so I don't know. I just can't make it down there in the morning, you know? I do miss that. That would be fun. Thanks for reminding me of that. Guys, if you want to share, let's get some more people in here. We'll get some questions. Let's light this thing up. Let's get it cranked. What's one thing you learned from Uncle G that has made the biggest difference in your life? Man, there's so many different things that I've actually learned from Grant. You know, dude, the things he's taught me about, like, just understanding, you know, what's going on, like, in the deal. Valuable, man. It's all inside the university for you, though. You know, it's all the stuff that he's telling you. I'm just hearing it from, like, I'm just hearing it from his voice, you know? So, like, it's not like he's not telling you the same stuff. You know, everything he's talking about all the time is, like, the stuff. I'm just paying attention all the time. You know, I keep listening to it, and I keep sucking it in. You know, how I look at him, and I see the way that he operates, it's like, just, he cares a lot, and, you know, but it's always like, dude, let's, you know, hustle. How do you get more? And, like, so I watch that. That's one thing that's really stuck with me for sure. You know, I feel like there's some similarities that I have, like, you know, because I'm not like I don't get all jacked up about certain things. I'm just like, let's go to the next deal, dude. Like, let's, okay, how much better can we do with this? So, I don't know. I like that about him. What other questions you guys have? Dude, let's get my hearts up. I'm trying to get to 1 million hearts on this thing. Pretty close. What other sales leader do you follow, read, learn from? Well, Gary Vaynerchuk was in our office yesterday doing a Power Players episode, which is freaking awesome. I like Gary. Gary's awesome. Gary's got some good shit. He's exciting dude. You know, he talks a lot about social media and things like that. And so, you know, I've watched some of his talks. There's not really a whole lot, man. I just feel like if I could get everything down that you know, Grant talks about and learn that, dude, I'd be freaking set for life. Wouldn't have to worry about anything, dude. So I focus a lot on that. What do you do on the weekends? What do you think I do on the weekends? Seriously, what do you guys think I do? It's probably the opposite of what you think I do. I don't do anything on the weekends, dude. And that's probably why, you know, some of the things that happen in my life, like the good things, and it's not always work, man. It's like I'll go out to dinner, but like I go out to nice places because I want to go around. I want to see what's happening, man. I go to the most expensive place I can go to for sure. You can't even get reservation. The last two reservations I've had were after 10:30, and I called a couple days ahead. Just the places that are packed, man. Everybody who's there are all freaking whales, you know. And that's what I want to do. Like I want to be around that. Like that's what gets me excited. I'm like, dude, these freaking old dogs, dude, just out here. Like that's what I want to be right now. So like I'm trying to figure it out. You know. But I'm always like reading stuff. Yeah, dude. Always on Kent Jones. Dude, he's got some good shit. As a chef, I understand. Dude, the whole chef game is freaking awesome. Like, that's something I'd like to explore. If I ever got a hobby, I think it'd be like figuring that out. You know, just cool ways, cool stuff to cook. You set your own appointments. Hit that back in. Sorry, I apologize. You get ready to knock down a multi-family deal. Dude, I got, you know, I hit the number. You know, the number that I said, hey, I need to have this amount of money in the bank before I can freaking do this thing. So now I'm like, now I'm looking. Now I'm excited about it. What are my long-term goals? Man, that's a great question. So, you know, the long-term goals are like investing things. Like I'm just trying to figure out, you know, like what game's next? Like what's the next exciting thing? Like I would like to do something, you know, really big where I could help people on a larger scale. I think that'd be awesome. You know, I don't even know what that would be. I don't really know what that would be. You know, I want to like write books, things like that. That'd be cool. Books you recommend? You know, there's a lot, man. There's just like so many. Like, what are you interested in? What is your favorite book that isn't Grant's? Probably Relentless by Tim Grover was probably one of the most impactful books for me that like got me jacked up. That was just a good book, man. I mean, hands down, that guy wrote some shit. But I'm also a basketball fan, and he coached, he actually trained Kobe, Michael Jordan, and Dwayne Wade. So, you know, interesting stories, pretty cool stuff. Go to school, get a degree in business, go work hard. Period. Yeah, man, get your deal on. Scuba, there's three prices for Cardone. Go back to that. Sorry, I'm going to answer for you. What hours do you work? Man, you know what? Like, I'm working in the mornings, like, before I even get to the office. But, you know, I show up 8:30, 8:45, 9 o'clock, and then stay till 7, 8 o'clock. But, you know, dude, I'm working right now pretty much, you know? Just trying to get my name out there. Trying to get out of obscurity with people. Like, that's, like, dude, it's like, I'm always working. I'm, like, living the work thing, you know? Like, it doesn't ever turn off. Does that mean that I don't like it? Like, that I don't enjoy the whole thing? I mean, dude, I get to sit here and hang out with you guys. You know? It's awesome. Oh, appreciate that, man. Dude, I see Chef Bill Roll, man. My man dropping in on Instagram. Dude, I appreciate you following. I just seen that pop down. Appreciate it. If you guys are following me on Instagram, go do it. That'd be awesome. Trying to get that space blown up. You're awesome. Thank you for that, Chad Sellers. You got it. Dude, my man, the chef. Dude, I'm going to have you down here so you can cook some crazy stuff, dude, because that, you know, cook something fancy. 24 and wanting to pursue sales, industry or company recommendations. Dude, look for a place that's got a lot of opportunity and places where nobody is doing anything. One place that I see every day, real estate agents. Fucking terrible, dude. Apologize to anybody that offends, I cuss. They're terrible. I mean, there's so many industries. Some of them I don't always agree with. Like, I couldn't even tell somebody to go do it. But what I would tell you to do is anything has to do with, like, knocking doors, man. Tons of opportunity there. I love that. Solar's pretty good. You know, alternative lending would be awesome. I like that. Dude, there's a lot of stuff out there that's pretty good, you know? Like, I don't know. Any business. How do you decide between staying committed and giving up good for great? You decide between staying committed. Dude, I'm just freaking, you know, the committed thing's like, dude, you just got to be committed. Oh, there's three prices for Cardone, 13K, 4K, and 1K. So the difference, the 4K is the real deal of, like, there's like over an extra 100 hours of content from Grant. If you want to watch them, like, on workshops, live video workshops, like, there's like 30 sales meetings with him and different organizations, and they're like stuff you've never seen and never will be able to see ever. There's about 100 hours of that in that $4,000 deal. The $1,000 deal is going to give you the full curriculum of all the training. So $995 is going to give you 12 months of full training. Yeah, you can call that number. You guys can email me, steve@grantcardone.com right now, and I'll just email you everything you need. Who fields advice calls at your office? Anybody, really. I mean, we're always willing to, like, help out. You know, a lot of people, like, you know, they want to call up and get, like, a 30-minute spiel on, like, hey, what should I do? And they forget that, like, we're working or something, you know? But, like, I'll tell you that we've got a ton of people there who, like, will take that time to stop and be like, dude, what's your problem? Let me handle it for you. Oh, that's your problem? Look, let me show you this. This will help you out. This will do that. So we've got a ton of people who actually do that. Oh, thank you, Paris. Appreciate that. What's up? Shani Somer in the house. What up, girl? How you doing? Yeah, appreciate all the shares, guys. Appreciate that. If you guys don't know who I am, if this is your first time to the Scope, my name's Steve Spray. I work with the godfather of sales, Grant Cardone. Is Cardone U good for insurance agents? Dude, Cardone U is for insurance agents. I did insurance. It was a freaking nightmare when I did it. Let me tell you why. One, I didn't know how to make phone calls properly. Number two, I didn't know how to pitch. So guess what? Guess what problem was a challenge for me? Oh, well, I'm getting a different price over here. Oh, okay. Well, I don't know how to freaking sell. So that was a problem. Number two, didn't know how to fill up my pipeline. Number three, didn't know how to cold call people. Number four, didn't know how to close. Number five, didn't know how to handle objections. Insurance was a nightmare for me. So yes, Cardone University is for insurance. Cardone University is for anybody who wants to get anything in their life. I just hooked somebody up today with Cardone University who has a, you know, they work, you know, he's got a, you know, salary job, not in sales, has nothing to do with sales, works in machinery. Dude, that guy is going to be a freaking, the knowledge, man, the knowledge, the information, you guys always got to be like learning. Like, that program's for everybody. What else have you sold? Only asking because you are the man, dude. Thanks. Let me tell you my jobs. So number one, I sold boats. That was my first job. And the reason why I got the job selling boats was because I walked into a dealership and I'm like looking around and I'm like, dude, it might be cool to work here. I hated the job I was in. And the manager hired me. He told me a week later that he hired me because he thought I looked cool to party with. So that was how I got into sales. You know, and then I went and sold insurance. Then I sold real estate, sold cell phones for like 4 months. I sold cars. And that's about it, man. But I've had other jobs, man. I sold Kirby at one point for like a little part-time deal, which was cool. That was freaking sick. I wish I would have put more attention on that. I didn't sell that many houses. Not that many houses at all. Not even enough to talk about, man. And there's more hearts on that screen right now than houses that I sold. What kind of insurance did you sell? Property and casualty. And I started to look into life, but you know, it's like, I didn't even give it enough time, man. There was no commitment there. And I didn't know how to sell. I didn't know how to sell. I didn't know how to do anything. So guess what, man? Every time somebody was like, oh, well, guess what, man? Freaking, I work for State Farm. So anytime anybody dropped, oh, well, thanks, man. Dude, you were awesome. But I got a better deal with Geico. And I'm like, oh, right on. Right on, bro. Appreciate it. Thanks, man. And that's exactly what happens to you guys every single day. If you don't have you don't know what to do. If you don't know where to go. If you don't know how to do it. Why are real estate agents so fucking terrible? Dude, that is a great question. I don't know, man. I really don't know what it is. There's a very small number of people in that industry that I talk to who are any good or who are even interested in being good, I think. I don't know, man. It blows my mind. I talk to them every single day. And out of all industries that really stick out for me, that's one of them. So if you're in that industry or you're looking to get in that industry, dude, turn up your skills because you will get to the top quick. I probably picked up a book to skill up when I was like 23, freaking sick of everything that was happening. Sitting in a place where I'm looking around, people making twice the money as me, and I'm like, what's not working here, man? I show up every day, stay late, okay? That was when I figured out I didn't have any skills, so I bought a book. Started from there, and then I'm like, oh man, my sales started to go up. Things are starting to work out. Then what happened was I moved from the book to, I went to a seminar. Did a seminar. Freaking light bulb turns on in my freaking head, and I'm like, oh my God, this guy's saying everything that I'm literally thinking in my head, but I've never said. Nobody around me is thinking, and he freaked me out from that day. Still remember that day. Okay, I was in Indianapolis, Indiana, had no idea who Grant Cardone was, but somebody took me to a seminar and it freaked me out. And anyways, from that day on, I mean, I started to invest myself. I got a version of the Cardone University at that point. I got a version of it, not what you guys have today, not the freaking banging deals that you guys have today. And literally in 6 weeks, I had tripled my income per week. So I've been doing that shit for a long time. You know, I'm still doing that today. I'm still doing all that stuff, you know? Yeah, dude, Hoosier Kane, what up? Yeah, I'm from Indianapolis, man. I grew up on the south side of Indianapolis, dude. You know where that's at. Been there, man. Once you get commit crazy, yeah, exactly. And I listen to a bunch of Kanye, so it gets my confidence up. You know what I'm saying? Dude, you know if you listen to Kanye, you got like an extra swag about you when you're listening to it. And then when you get done listening to it, you know you just feel a little bit better. Is the price a one-time fee or yearly? Yeah, it's a one-time fee, but it lasts for the entire year. So you pay the $1,000, lasts you a whole year. And when was the last time you invested $1,000 in yourself? Okay? Most people never have. Okay, here's what happens. Most people never have invested $1,000 in themselves. And I'm sorry, man. I'm going to tell you right now, dude, that's exactly why you're not getting what you want. Okay? If it's not that program, what's it going to be? Like, when are you going to, like, feel good enough about yourself to say, dude, I'm worth it to freaking do that. I'm worth it to actually do that, right? You do it every day. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. Okay? If you think that you're worth it enough every day to get up and take care of your body and, like, go for a run, like, you need to do that, man. You need to feel that confident about yourself, or, like, you need to say, like, dude, I'm worth it to, like, take care of myself, to, like, eat good, right? So why don't you ever, like, invest in your mind or, like, your job or, like, what you do to, like, get money? You know? So it's pretty much that. Guys, I appreciate the hearts. Who's a first-timer tonight? 20%? 20% what? Boom! Scuba Steve. Perfect answer. Oh, thanks. or more if it's an Adele concert. Oh, you guys are talking to each other. I already know what you're talking about. First timer, Joe, what's up, man? How you doing? Nice to meet you, Joe. My name is Steve Spray. I'm a sales manager. I work with a guy named Grant Cardone. He's a New York Times bestselling author. He's a sales trainer. He's the number one freaking sales godfather on the planet, which is cool, man. That's why I started the Scope, because I wanted to get on and answer some questions for you guys. I'm in the market for a car. Is it better to lease or buy? Dude, lease. Never buy. Why do they call you Scuba Steve? Let me answer the question about the Scuba Steve. That's a great question. So, it's from the movie, dude. It's from the Adam Sandler movie that came out. My dad used to call me that. Ever since he's seen that movie, he called me that. And then when I came to the office, one day I'm sitting in the office, I'm trying to figure out, because some guy, and if there's any freaking Canadians on here and you know how to track down this Steve Spray who's been freaking hanging on to my handle since 2009, I want you to find him, dude, because I've been trying to contact him for like 6 years now. Anyways, yeah, he's a Canadian. He's probably a real nice guy. If I could just figure out how to get in touch with him, he'd probably just be like, yeah, dude, I haven't tweeted since 2009. But anyway, so we're sitting there trying to figure out like what we could change my Twitter name to. And the guy in there, my manager at the time, he'd called me Scuba Steve from day one. And he'd always laughed about it. So I put it up there, Scuba Steve. And then what happened was that everybody started calling me that. And now it's kind of like, can't get rid of it. Unless you guys find that guy in Canada who's got my handle, then I will change it. I just can't get hold of him. Why lease over buy? Dude, there's a lot of reasons why you should lease over buy. For me, dude, I mean, I change cars all the time, you know? I just get sick of them. Number two, the payments are lower. Number three, how much money does that car make you? Oh, that should trump everything right there. Listening to 10X for the fifth time. Finally getting some of it. Thank you. Oh, my God. Thank you for that. Email me your name. Email me your name, steve@grantcardone.com. I'm just going to send you a gift. Because that's what I'm talking about, man. I've been telling people all the time, like, dude, you've got to listen to it more than once. You got to listen to it 5, 10, 15 times. I still listen to 10X Roll every morning. I still listen to this audio Grant did from freaking back in the day. You can't even get it in MP3 form. I had this thing made by one of the old tech guys in our office. I don't even know how he got it on here. But I listened to it and it's like so juicy. But like I listen to it over and over and over again because it's really good stuff. You gotta blow it up, man. Best lead by example moment you witnessed from Uncle G. Well, I mean, it's freaking every day, you know? Every day, man. He's just, he's pushing a lot harder. Like he shows up before most people. And then he's also still working after most people. And when he's at home, he's still doing streams for like an hour. You know, dude, every time I see that, I'm like, fuck, I should be working. Which I typically am. It's just that, you know, I'm like, dude, I don't even have a family. I'm not even doing that. I don't have five businesses. You work for Ken Wallace? What's up, man? How you doing? He knows Grant, everybody, the Boiler Room. What's up, man? Dude, nice to have you on. Love new friends. Love new friends. Spill the beans on the greatest sales secret. Yeah, if you just mail me a check, you guys can mail it. Email me. Email me, Alan. You know where my address is. Email me. And then I'll send you an invoice for $5,000 and I will give you the secret. I'm just kidding. I wouldn't do that, dude. I wouldn't even do that to you. That'd be freaking sick if I did that. It would be unethical if I did that. Come on, Alan. Dude, the webcast is going to be awesome. If you guys haven't signed up for the greatest sales secret, I will tell you that. When they told me that they were going to do this webcast, I was like, dude, now that's, you know, that's something people freaking need to know about. And, you know, and then Grant's like, well, let's not tell them what it is up front, you know, because most people don't freaking know about it. And I will tell you that it is one of the things that has made me the most money, for sure. And nobody understands it, I promise you. They don't understand it in any way that like what Grant understands it. And he definitely changed the way I did. So if you guys haven't got it, the greatest sales secret of all time is a webcast Grant's doing on February 18th. You can get it at greatestsalessecret.com. It's $49, changed the game for you, I promise. Consistency, nah man, it's nothing wide like that. It's nothing like that. It is something that you're going to be able to take away that night and get a deal, I promise you. And then it's going to change the way you sell. It's going to change the way you sell. It's going to change the way you operate when you get things that you want. It will change the way you operate when trying to get things that you want. And if even half of what I'm telling you is true, go to greatestsalessecret.com and pick it up. It's free, $49. I know what it is. Oleg, what up? Yay. Can I say? Dude, you guys can say whatever you want to. I'll never answer. I'll never do it. All right, what questions do you guys have? I want to answer a couple questions. I think I've been on for like 30 minutes. Hey, question ever dealt with being plugged in with too many coaches? No. Nah, I mean, I've never been plugged in with too many at all. I've never been plugged in with that. You know, I think there's a lot of great coaches out there. I think what you could do, though, see, because I think a lot of people have different opinions. So I think if you really try to, like, study one person or one thing, and because most people are, like, you know, the gurus or whatever in their space, right? So, like, whatever you have attention on or, like, whatever you're focused with, I think you would, like, want to find out, like, dude, who's the major player in this area, or like who's the top 1, 2, 3 players in this area, and then figure out everything that you can about them and study them. I think that would be ideal. Steve, you got my name right. Most people don't. Where are you from, Oleg? Where are you from? What is your best PNC cold call for commercial business? Well, do you have Cardone University? Number one, you want to identify like why you're giving them a call. You know? You want to give them a call. You want to give them a hook, okay? Because here's what's happening is that you're not giving them a hook. You're just calling them and say, hey, I'm going to give you a free quote. They're like, dude, I'm freaking up to here in freaking free quotes. Dude, I don't need any more free quotes. Please don't give me another free quote. Okay? I don't want one. I would actually pay you to not give me a free quote. So you need to get a better hook, dude. You need to get a better hook on what's actually happening so you can use it. This is a Ted Baker shirt. So you want to be able to get a hook that you can call up with. You know, hey, this is Steve from PNC, Property Casualty Insurance. And what I want to do is get you set up with something that's going to save you another 30% in your insurance quotes right now. Okay? Not even the saving the 30%, I don't even like that. I need to figure out a better quote. Maybe email me, Steve, at grantcardone.com. What's a big claim that you have? Because what I'd love to do is just really figure out like where you could go with that. I just need like a better hook. I don't know what the claim is for that because I don't have commercial properties. But it needs to be something that's catchy where a business owner is going to be like, oh, yeah, I might look at that. Okay? And it's not always about saving money because he might not be – you know, he's always looking at that, but he's only looking at it a couple times throughout the year. So I think you need to figure out something else. What's that guy's problem? Right? What's that guy's real problem? What would solve his problem? What problems does he have? Okay, he has time problems. You know, he has, you know. Think about those things. Email me, man. I'll brainstorm it with you. What questions do you guys have? Steve, in your opinion, what would be a big hook for selling TV advertising? Dude, you guys always ask me this stuff, but, you know, like, it's your industry, man. Like, you know, I don't know anything about TV advertising. You guys see that TV right there? Okay. You want to know why I bought that? I bought that TV because Todd Straw walked into my place. He's like, dude, you don't have a freaking TV? I'm like, dude, I haven't watched a TV in 4 years. He's like, dude, but everybody has a TV. You just got to have one. I'm like, all right, whatever, dude. Freaking buy a TV. So I bought the TV. The reason why I'm telling you that is because, dude, I don't know anything about TV advertisements, right? I don't know anything about views or impressions. But what I would take a look at is, dude, what are the big claims? What are people's problems? People only buy things because they want to solve a problem, okay? So what problem is that guy trying to solve? If he's advertising, okay, he can't freaking sell, okay? That's his problem. He can't sell if he is advertising, okay? If he's advertising, what other problems are you trying to solve? Traffic. Hey, look, man, give me a call. What we want to do is get you set up with something. We got something brand new that's causing a massive spike in the amount of traffic to organizations like yours in your space with this one thing. We want to spend about 6-8 minutes with you showing you exactly what it is. Do you have time today or tomorrow? Okay, that might be like a quick pitch, you know. Figure out, dude, figure out what that guy's problem is. Figure out what he's doing. Yeah. Their personality types, sure. Yeah, I like that. How do I motivate my guys? Dude, if you guys don't do sales meetings every single day, if you don't have your people writing down their goals, like you gotta have people writing down their goals. Dude, I gotta do it every day, okay? I get freaking bored. You know, I get demotivated. I'm going to work every day. I'm like, oh my God, I gotta make more calls. I gotta talk to more clients. I gotta do more sales meetings. I gotta rewrite more pitches. Like, dude, it's the same freaking thing that you do every single day, dude. Every single day you're going through and doing that. And like, so like sometimes, dude, you gotta have something else to like get you to like click back in. Like, oh yeah, that's why I show up freaking every day to like hustle. And oh yeah, I wanna help, you know, a billion people. Oh, that's why I write all these freaking free scripts for people and help them out. Oh yeah, that's why I wanna do that. Oh yeah, but it always goes back to the goals, man. You gotta write your goals down every day. And you gotta hold people accountable. You gotta hold people accountable around you for writing their goals down. One thing that we do in my office, me and Jordan Stupar actually write each other's goals down. So this is something, I don't even know why. One day we came up with it. This is how serious we are about goals. I said, dude, let me write that. Cause he had this big goal that he was going for last year. And so I was like, okay, well, dude, I'm going to write that goal down because I want you to get that. If you get that, I know for sure that these other things are going to happen for me. So I wrote his goal down and dude, things start popping up. So I don't know. It's magic, man. Writing your goals down is magic. So that is how you stay motivated. That's how you stay excited every day. And that's how you like realize what you're doing every day. Right? Why you're making all those phone calls, like why, you know, you keep showing up every day, you know? Dude, I could walk out here to the beach every single morning and be freaking awesome, right? But I don't. I go to the office every single day, and if I wasn't writing down my goals, dude, that's, you know, that I wouldn't even be able to figure it out, man. I'd be like smoking weed or, you know, I'd be getting drunk all the time or something like that. You know, what people do when they get bored and they don't have a purpose. I hope that answered your question. You write the same goals every day? Not, dude, they're kind of different. They're different, man. They're different. They're like the same goals, but they change, man. They change all the time. You know, I look back at goals. Like, I remember for the longest time, I wrote down that I wanted to live in this one particular building. Okay? I wrote down that I wanted to live in this one particular building. And what had happened was that I finally got to a point where I could afford it. And man, I thought, dude, if I freaking move in here, this place is going to be freaking sick. It's going to be fucking badass. It's going to be fucking awesome. The goals that I was writing down, I literally skyrocketed at this one. There was like a bump. There was like a breakthrough. And I busted through that so quick that I literally moved into that building. And within like 60 days, I'm literally sitting in there thinking about, I had to get new furniture for the place. And I was already like, dude, I need to move out of this place, because I'm looking at the place next door and I'm like, I could probably afford to live there, and that place is freaking way sicker than this place, you know? And so like the goals always change, you know, like the goals are always different. Like they're always different. Like they're, you know, a year ago I had like a relationship, you know, I had like different goals when I had that, you know, now I don't. Now I've got a whole different set of goals, you know? And so different things are going to happen, you know, every day. But you always got to write them down, man, because if you don't have a purpose, you got to know which deals are paying for your new stuff. Yeah, man, you got to wake up. You got to know, you got to ask yourself, who's got my money? Will you still be working for GC in 5 years? Dude, I hope so. I hope so. Because if I am, dude, that means we're freaking huge. That means we are massively huge. And I definitely know that that's where they're going. Like, I have no reason to leave there. You know, I don't. There would be a reason for me to do that. Right? I'm around a bunch of people who think the same things as me, who want to do the same things as me. Like, dude, us is like a team, way better, way bigger, way more opportunity, and way more support. You know, you got there by yourself, dude, you're all by yourself. You know? A lot of people talk about that. They're like, dude, why don't you go do it by yourself? I'm like, because I don't want to be by myself, bro. And I don't want to start back over. I'm like, dude, things are going pretty well. I want to push my team up, man. I think my team could do really well. Are you doing a multifamily deal this year? Yes. Yeah, I am. Yeah, I'm excited about it. It's like the one thing. It's like, you know, one of the things that gets me excited every day. Do you make more money in network marketing? No, I don't do network marketing. Do you have a degree in what? No, I dropped out of community college, actually. Thanks for asking. What I did was I got my freaking skills on. which is funny. I was thinking about this when I moved into this place, and so I met my neighbors. So I'm a community college dropout, by the way. And I'm sitting here, both of my neighbors, so they're married, but they're both surgeons. And so I'm meeting them, and like, I'm just like cracking up. I'm like, I live next to two, they live together, surgeons, freaking banking, and I'm a freaking 29-year-old living next door to them. I'm like, dude, I mean, I had some swag after I freaking left that deal. After I left that elevator talk, I walked out with some swag. I was like, dude, you know, shit's real, man. Shit's real. There's some, you know, doesn't matter, dude. It's about the skills. It's about like figuring out like, look, how can I get to that next level? You know, I felt good about it. Yeah, they have $500K in college debt. Yeah, they do. That's what I'm saying, man. It's like, you know, you guys can all do it. You know, you don't have to, you don't have to go to college to like if you're going to go to college, make sure there's a purpose. Like, why are you there, dude? If you're going to be a surgeon, like that would make sense to go to college. Okay. If you're going to go to college for general studies, don't freaking go, dude. Figure something else out. You could learn more from just like reading books. Yeah, you know, I wouldn't suggest going to college unless you're being a lawyer, a doctor, something specific, man, unless there's something. Now, like, am I against the education? Definitely not. Like, I would love to go get like a structured learning, but, you know, it's a new deal. That's why they got Udemy. I went to Ball State. Oh, dude, my man, you went to Ball State? Dude, I went up there a couple different times. I know what y'all got up there. You guys party a lot. Love it. Love it. How do you help your team when they are having a shitty week on the phone? It happens, man. Dude, it happens. So, you know, basically, you got to role play with them. You got to confront them. Whenever you're doing bad, so this is one thing that I learned from Grant. He said, dude, when you can't get a deal, flip it, dude. Go close a deal for somebody else. Because you get this thing like, you know, and it kind of reminded me too, like, you know, back in the day when I was like, you know, when I was like when you're, you know, you're with like, you were younger, like the college guy, right? You know, and like they're in the group and, you know, you didn't really care, but your friend was like, hey, I like that girl, go talk to her for me, right? And she was freaking smoking and you already had a girlfriend, but you didn't really care about how to like talk to her. So like you'd go up and, you know, the swag was on, like, yeah, you know, blah, 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 whatever. But like if that was you who liked them, you wouldn't do it. And I feel like that's the same thing with this thing that Grant taught us to do. He said, if you're not closing a deal, if you can't close a deal, if you're having trouble, go close somebody else's deal, because you take off that like concern, you know, like you don't have it's like you just feel like real open about it. And that like natural self like comes out where you're just like, you know, you give the guy a call, you're talking real, you're doing the real deal, or you're in front of him, like go close somebody else's deal so you can get that like confidence back. Hope that answered your question. Was there tension in the office yesterday with GC and GV? Yeah, you know what? A little bit. But they're just like fun guys, man. They're just like smart guys, you know. It was good. I mean, there wasn't a whole lot of tension. How many no's you get a day? I get a lot, man. I get a lot. Most people just don't know me, you know, so I get a lot of not no's. If you could choose rather work from home or office, do office every single time. I've worked from home and it freaking killed me because I can't get, there's too many things that like take my attention off of really work. Oh, shut up. Thanks, Johnny. Dude, I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that. I appreciate you coming in here. See, now this is what I'm talking about, dude. We've only got 99 people in here and that's why I've only got one hater. That's why you guys got to get more people. You got to get out of obscurity. What did you think about Gary Vaynerchuk saying about less calls and more research on prospects? I partially agree with them based off who you're contacting. So there's he's definitely right. He's for sure right. thanks, man. He's definitely right. You should definitely get to know better, like, the people that you're contacting and calling, because it's going to help you, right? Like, you're not always going for volume. Like, I think a lot of people think that in our office, like, we just dial for dollars when we really don't. We're making a lot of phone calls to people that we're studying outside of the office. Like, we create all of our, like, prospecting lists And so when I go research, you know, who they are, I've got to find out who they are. I got to go to their LinkedIn. I got to figure out what they are. And like, I'm looking on there and like, I'm just knowing, I'm like figuring out what's happening with these people. So like when I call them, I'm like, I know what's up. Or like, if I'm contacting this like crazy business owner, I'm going to find out what articles he's written. And I'm going to read those articles. I'm not going to do it at the office, but I'm doing it at home. So I'm like studying the people that I'm calling. Some people think I'm a smart guy. I don't know. And so like, that's another thing. So like, I think he was 100% right about what he was saying. I just think you got to like take that and like really think with it about like, what's he really saying? Okay. What's he really saying? You guys got to really look at. What do you look for in LinkedIn profiles for a possible career? What do you look for in LinkedIn profiles? What I look for on LinkedIn profiles, I'm stalking people on LinkedIn. So what I'm doing is I'm scrolling all the way to the bottom and I'm figuring out where they went to school. I'm figuring out who they were. So I can learn everything I need to know about you by knowing where you went to school, by what you like, what little things you clicked on. Okay, that tells me everything. Your like little fake bio up top, that doesn't really tell me a whole lot, you know? So like, but what I also, most people write articles or have done something like that. And so when you search their name and articles, it'll pop up, you know, and there'll be like something, you can go read it. And so that way you can like figure people out a little bit more. You can like understand them and have a better reality of like who they are and like what type of person they are. Like, I got a deal right now that I closed, that I for sure know that I closed the deal because there was one thing for 1 second that was brought up during the phone call and it was a big deal. And I guarantee you that whole thing broke the entire ice on everything off this one little thing that he had no idea that I knew. Yeah, thank you. I missed a question I think that rolled up. It was a big one. I always feel bad when the big ones roll by because I know there's some meat in there. There's actually somebody who's got like a real thick question that they want answered, and I want to answer that for you. If you want to send that back in. Guys, I appreciate the hearts. If you guys aren't following me on Instagram, go follow me at Steve Spray. I'm going to do the best I can to entertain you on that platform more. Not that I don't already, I guess. You guys can follow me on Snapchat too. I'm pretty active on there. How much are you on track for this year? Pretty close to 7 figures. You know, it's only been 1 month. You know, so I'm trying to bust that. I'm really trying to bust it. I asked about how can I network being an 18-year-old? What are good strategies? Dude, get to know everybody you can. Figure out who's doing well. Figure out, like, that was one thing for me. I remember, like, all the people that I hung around, I was always reaching up. That was something that I naturally had. I'm always, like, all the people that I was around, I was always, like, reaching up. I remember, like, even when I got out of high school, like, there was a group of people I'm, like, dude, there's something going on with these guys that I'm like interested in. So like I'm reaching up, you know, and then like that was cool and everything. And I learned a lot and like just things change over time. And like the next person that I like really like became good friends with, I like reached up like real big, you know, he's like a guy who's like doing well, you know, and I'm like learning from him and I'm like listening to him and I'm always like listening to what people say. And like, I'm like really thinking like, dude, why are they saying that? Or like, what are they really saying? Like, what are they say it, but like, what do they mean? You know? And so, you know, then I really freaking reached out, freaking huge. And that's what you need to do, man. That's what you need to do. You need to get around people who are thinking, like, stay away from people that, like, not that you don't have to stay away from, because it's like, a lot of it's probably the people that are in your family, you know? It's like, they just got such a little think. My Instagram is at Steve Spray. So it's at Steve Spray. Follow me on there if you're not, man. I would appreciate if you guys followed me on there. Hello, how you doing? Lou, how you doing? How do you set targets that motivate and don't turn you out? Do my targets are always used with this math right here? Okay. Okay, I'm trying to make $1 million this year, right? My target that I write down every day shows that I make $10 million this year, okay? The things that I focus on that I need to think with every day that I'm always trying to do would match what I'm writing down every single day. I go through 3 or 4 planners a year probably. But I got a lot of notes. I got a lot of stuff. I'm writing all in them. I mean, I could probably sell this thing for, I mean, I guarantee if somebody knew what was in there. I mean, if you guys really, you guys come find me, you want to jump me, you want to take my wallet, or you want to take that thing, there's freaking way more money in it, in that thing. Do you have any forms of passive income? Dude, that is what I have my attention on this year, right? So I write down every single day, I have $2 million of passive income. Now, you're sitting here saying, dude, do you know what it takes to get there? And yes, I do, because I've done the math. I freaking said, look, this is where I need to be at. This is what I need to freaking hit. What do I need to do to get there? And so like, that's what I'm thinking with every single day. And that's what all my targets are. And when I'm thinking, dude, who's got my money? And I'm trying to figure out prospects to call. Well, I don't call the things that aren't going to get me on track for that target. There's people that I can call right now and get a deal from. Probably right now. I know for sure I can do that. There's also people that I could call and I could really work that would put me on target to get what I want. So like, you got to do that math, you know? And so like, I want a lot of that. I've got a serious question. What happened to my steak and lobster? Alina, what happened to you? I haven't seen you on here in forever. You come over, I'll cook you a steak. Right now, I don't have any, but if you got the steak, you bring it over. How do you figure out who to call? Dude, that, I mean, it's like, you know, it's so wide open in my industry. My last name is Spray. It's S-P-R-A-Y. S-P-R-A-Y. So my Instagram is at Steve Spray. I'll buy you a steak. I'll take you out. We can go to, I always go to the Matador Room, so we can go there. Damn it. What was that question that I was on? That was a good question. I apologize. That was my fault. I got off of it. See, that's how long it takes less than a second for somebody to steal the attention. You guys are losing deals like that every day. I'm telling you. Whoever sent that question, send that back in, because I apologize. My chat, my Snapchat's Steve Spray. How do you know who to call? Thank you. All right, so I'm going to answer that question. So in my business, there's so much opportunity. It's so like wide. It's so wide range. That's where I've got to really like sit down and say, okay, good. Who do I really want to call? Who's going to give me the money? And that's where I really start doing research on people, okay? And I start finding out, dude, who are the players in this industry, okay? Then what I really ask is, who's done this before? Because that person that who hasn't done what I'm selling them, if they haven't done it before, dude, chances are I'm not going to close them on a freaking cold call. I'm not even going to get to them on a cold call. They're gonna be like, dude, why are you calling me? Okay? I do sales training, right? I sell people who have interest in sales and growing their business. People who spend a lot of money on advertising, they don't freaking know how to sell, and they don't... It probably is, Jay. It probably is right now. Anyways, back in my comment, the people who do the advertising, dude, they don't know how to sell and they don't care about selling. They're like, dude, I'm going to throw $100,000 a month at this deal and here's what I'm going to get. Okay, they did their math and that's what they figured out. They have no interest in the getting better thing, right? So like, I don't call those people. I call the people that I'm like, okay, I see them doing this in the space. I'm trying to flip them. Are you guys dressing like you can afford your products? I typically do. I think most of my suits are, you know, $900. Most of my shoes are probably $400 a piece. I mean, I'd say most of the outfits that I have on are about $1,500. So, you know, I don't know. I think so. All right, John. I thought it was a smart ass question. So that's why I was giving you a smart ass answer. Yeah. Well, you know. I probably get the shoe thing from Heath Powell because he's got six shoes, so you got to stay tight in that office. How can we increase the number of calls without dialers? Write this down. Organization, okay? Everything is about organization, guys. If you can figure that out, if you can figure out how to get super freaking organized in your life, you'll all be millionaires, and you could probably have no skills. I'm telling you, the organization... Like, you definitely need skills, but what I'm saying is that the organization is like one thing I've major attention on this year. I'm like, dude, how can I tighten up everything? Because everybody that I'm around, so if you look at the Grants, the Gary Vaynerchuk, I hear him saying the same freaking thing every single time they talk. They're counting the minutes. They're counting the minutes. They're not counting the hours. They're not looking at the days. Grant's looking at the minutes. I'm like, dude, why is he always looking at the minutes? Why does he care how much he gets done in the next 6 minutes? Why is he paying attention to you know what just happened over the past 3 minutes? I'm like, dude, these guys are really counting this whole deal. I'm like, dude, it's the organization thing. I'm like, dude, Grant doesn't want to do that one thing, not because it's not going to make money, because it's not the most productive thing for that amount of time. And I'm like, seeing all this stuff, and I'm like, okay, organization is freaking key. So yeah, you want to do that. You can definitely make more phone calls if you come, show up, have a list, have material. Now, if you're like Alina, now that is a real ninja. If you count the seconds, do that, you'll probably be a billionaire before 30. What's the greatest sales secrecy? I can't tell you, man. I'd love to tell you. All right, guys, I think I've been on here for like an hour. I'm gonna get going because I got some stuff to do myself. You guys have a great night. I appreciate you guys being on. Write this down. I'm gonna have you write this down. Get a pen, get one of these, write this down. At Steve Spray. That's my Instagram, and that's how you guys control the scopes, guys. Go follow me on Instagram, please. I'm looking for more. Thanks, man. Always taking notes. Appreciate that. Yeah, guys, I really hoped you out. Seriously, that's why I do these. I just want to make sure you guys are doing well. Reach out to me if you ever need anything. You guys, have a great night.